everyone. My name is Gina Barge, and I would like to thank all of you for coming out to the Gene Barge Appreciation Event. Hi, Dad. As you probably all know, Gene Barge has enjoyed a 50-plus year musical career, and his productions, arrangements, and saxophone stylings have appeared in recordings in jazz, blues, rock and roll, gospel, R&B, and hip-hop. And he's worked with some of the most renowned artists, including Muddy Waters, Howlin' Wolf, Coco Taylor, Natalie Cole, The Rolling Stones, and Public Enemy, to name a few. He's also appeared in several feature films and documentaries, and what I find most interesting, personally, is that a lot of people will recognize him on the street based on his role in the movie The Fugitive. And if you haven't seen that, take a look at this.
Yes, we have a gun in the house.
Is it registered your name?
Yes.
Where do you usually keep that gun?
It's in
the one that you own.
It's in the home, it's dead. Bedside table.
You keep a large amount of jewelry in the house?
Hello. His fingerprints are all over the lamp, the gun, and the bullets. And the good doctor's skin is under her fingernails.
Your wife, she's got the money in the family, doesn't she?
What some of you also may not know is that Gene Barge starred in a film titled Stony Island, which also gave him a chance to show off some of his musical talent. So take a look at this clip.
Hey, it sounds great, you know, but just play it a little gentler, you know, just a little, just cool, just play sweet, okay? Go ahead.
Thank you. A few people really wanted to be here tonight, but instead of that, they've sent their message via video, and they need no introduction from me. So without further ado, here they are.
Well, one of the things, you know, sometimes things are funny like this. You know, we had a black union when I met Gene, musician union.
Uh-huh.
And they gave him a hard time. This is how we became good friends. And I was pretty good with the union, and they didn't want him to play because I think he's from Virginia or something. And I said, man, I need a horn player. He said, well, I can't play because they won't let me play. I said, oh, they'll let you play. And then I went down to the union. I said, look, I don't care what it costs. I got to have him to play. And they said, well, we're going to give him to you, but he can't play with nobody else. And we laugh about that now. But, you know, people like Gene come along once in a lifetime. When I met Gene, I didn't know he had made hit records with Chuck Willis. He had been affiliated with a lot of great music, and I think that's why Chestnut brought him in there, and him and I just clicked off, and ever since that day, we've never lost anything. We played a lot together with no rehearsal. We laugh about it now that we take young people out and rehearse them, and they still don't play like we used to play without the rehearsal. So, you know, we are the type of people that I think we was in love with the we was more in love with the music than we were the money at the time. We just had so much fun playing together, and it's hard to meet, it's hard to find people. Matter of fact, you don't find people like that anymore. So, hooray, Gene. Keep it up, man, you know. And we talked the other night, and we laughed about it, that we look around, and him and I are about the last two left going out there to Chess, you know. So we're just going to try to enjoy and have fun the rest of our life. Keep on keeping on, Gene. Keep on blowing the horn, Gene. Because, matter of fact, my dad saw Gene play with me and Gary in the other a couple of years before his dad died. He said, Gene, blow your horn like Gable blows his trumpet.
Hi, I'm Andy Davis, and I'm sorry I can't be with you all tonight to celebrate Gene Barge's terrific career in life. He's been an inspiration to so many people, a mentor and a guide and a good friend to so many of us. And your role in my career is instrumental because Stony Island was my first film, and you helped put together all the music, introduced me to great musicians like Larry Ball and Phil Upchurch, Tennyson Stevens, Windy Barnes, Chris Johnson, many others. And I knew that you had talent, but I didn't realize what a natural you were until we worked together. And I've put you in many movies, and you have been revered on the sets with Harrison Ford and Tommy Lee Jones and Morgan Freeman. And just the crews, they love you, and because you're a kind, sweet, supportive guy. And every time I mention your name to someone like Quincy Jones, he goes, oh, say hello to Gene. Gene's great. I remember the stories about, he told me Martin Luther King used to request you to play specific songs that he learned to love hearing you play. And your background in Chicago and with Chess and Stax in Memphis and working in L.A. with Natalie Cole and hundreds of sessions you've done with great musicians is not forgotten. Chuck D always talks about your incredible role in the world of music. And I just want to thank you for being so much a part of Richie's life and my life and being so supportive, and your patience and kindness, your sense of history as a veteran, your sense of history as a musician will not be forgotten. And I know you're not gone yet, but you will be dearly missed at whatever time you go. So stick around for another 20 years. We want to keep hearing this amazing man play. We love you. Good night.
Hey, how you doing? This is Chuck D from the group Public Enemy. Also sending out a very special holla and a shout, as we say, out to Daddy G, Gene Barge. I first had the pleasure to meet Mr. Barge, Daddy G, upon being requested to work for the Godfathers and Sons documentary, where he actually tied everything together. And reading Nadine Horner's book, Spinning Blues into Gold, about Chess Records, I read some chapters talking about the prowess of Daddy G as a producer, and I seen that come to fruition upon working on the project with him, and also, you know, coming into and visiting him for the first time. Matter of fact, his daughter Gina Barge became a very good friend of mine, actually was working for the film as well, and had been very instrumental on us going to, I think it was Robert Nighthawk's club, and all sitting together and mapping out what would be done on a documentary. Godfathers and Sons got high accolades, and, you know, Daddy G put it all together. I think another memorable event with Daddy G, and there's quite a few, just, you know, getting to know him. One was playing on the stage with him as he produced the show of Godfathers and Sons. I mean, all the Electric Mud Band had gotten together. So he actually had gotten that whole production together with Marshall Chess in the studio, but also it kind of arranged things on stage and make it happen in Chicago. He opened the door for me meeting a lot of the greats and also the dialogue with a lot of the greats. I remember the time I went down to Florida and I told him I had done a session with Bo Diddley. He commenced to tell me a whole bunch of, you know, Bo Diddley stories that, you know, were from the day that were really, you know, incredible stories as well. So, and also the real pleasure with Daddy G is that he graced us and he blessed Public Enemy by playing on two of our albums, New World Order in 2005, on a song called Superman's Black in the Building, and also 2007 on our album How You Sell Soul. The name of the track was Escapism. And I remember, you know, being in the studio and cutting those sax parts for those two songs. He just was adamant about, like, yo, man, I don't know about this rap thing, but what key? What key? What key? And every time he would say that, I kept thinking about what they said Ray Charles used to say whiskey or something. I didn't know, you know. I still don't know what they mean by key or whatever. All I know is, sound good, let's do it. So, anyway, big ups. All peace and love, much love to Daddy G. He keeps doing his thing, and I always, you know, check up on him, you know, as he's still the man with the master plan around Chi-Town doing his thing. So I love you, and happy belated Father's Day, Daddy G, Gene Barge. He's the greatest, all right? I'm Chuck D, Public Enemy, you know. Peace out to you and the fam. Thank you.
Hey, Daddy G. It's your boy, Gary U.S. Bonds. Look alive, Jack. Hey, I understand they're giving you an appreciation party up there in the big city, huh? They appreciate you. It's about time, man. Yeah, I mean, you deserve it. I mean, I appreciate you. I don't know how they can appreciate you more than I do, man, because, you know, you're the one who helped me get all my big hits back in the day, you know? We had a lot of fun back then. I wanted to tell a story about, you know, what we were doing back in the day, but I understand you're also in mixed company, so I better not do that until we get together. But I want you to have a good night, man. You deserve it. And you should have an appreciation night every night, as far as I'm concerned. Love you, Daddy. God bless you, my man. See you when I get there, genius.
Thanks, everyone, so much for coming out. Dad, we love you, and we expect to see and hear more from you in the future. So don't go anywhere. Good night.